calculating your monthly payment. A common misunderstanding
We are Invoke. My name's Zach. That's Carl. It's Jeff and Nick. And really excited to be playing tonight on Get Music, Get Happy Hour with the Civic Music Association out in Des Moines, Iowa. Thanks, Peter, for reaching out and asking if we'd want to participate. And it's really fun to be doing so. It's not very often that we get to play with each other anymore. So we'll take the chance. We'll take the opportunity. As you can see, we're outside in Nick's backyard here in Austin, Texas. We're standing about 6 feet apart, wearing masks, because Texas is a big hotspot right now, if you haven't heard on all of the news places. And so we're trying to be extra careful. And we're going to start off with a classic tune by Invoke. We call it Revel because it's the theme song for a local radio, not station, what's it? Program.
Show.
Radio show called Revel on KMFA Classical Austin. And we were given the chance to write the theme song. So this is Revel by Nick. I guess I'll have to tell him right now. So we're playing, next up is Strum by an awesome composer, Jessie Montgomery. She's out based in New York, and Carl brought this piece to the attention of the group and really wanted to play it, and for good reason, because it feels like we can really connect to it with our style. Jessie herself is a string player in the Catalyst Quartet, another amazing ensemble, which if you haven't heard of, you should go check out. And check out Jessie's work. She's kind of becoming a star compositionally in her own right now, and we've got to get contacting her to write us something, maybe. someday. Would be fun. So this is Jesse Montgomery's strum, and you'll quickly hear why it's called strum. Thank you. outside right now because this morning until about 2 hours ago, it was raining pretty consistently. You wouldn't know because it's nice and sunny out right now, but we were crossing our fingers, hoping that we didn't have to move inside for y'all. So, we gotta fix some stuff.
I'm gonna read the chats.
Oh, that's good. Okay, so just the video is messed up, but everything else is fine. So you can hear me speaking. This is my voice.
And the sound of this room.
The sound of this room. It's an inside joke. So yeah, it's you guys can feel free to comment wherever you're tuning in from Facebook on the Civic Music Association's Facebook page or their YouTube channel or our Twitch channel or our Facebook page. We're going to get your comments and we're going to have some time kind of in the middle to, you know, answer any questions you have. Say hi if you're watching from afar and know us. Even if you don't know us, say hi. Up next, when Nick gets back, we're going to be playing a piece by a close friend of ours, Danny Clay. He's a composer based out in San Francisco. He works a lot in experimental kind of art creation, music creation. He works a lot with kids on graphic score design, all sorts of really cool stuff. He worked with the San Francisco Children's Opera recently to make a basically an opera, like a quarantine opera, where all the kids sent in videos of them playing their various parts in the opera and they spliced it up. It was really cool. Definitely check out what Danny's up to now. The piece we're about to play is one of his first. It's called Good Night. I like to call it a hymn to America. It's just a very powerful piece, very simple, and we hope you really enjoy it. After that, we're gonna do Paul Wianco's piece. Paul Wianco is a cellist out of New York as well, but you might know him from touring recently with the Cronus Quartet. He used to be part of the Harlem Quartet, and he's an amazing composer, and lots of string quartets are now writing him to write them a piece, including us, hopefully soon. But this is the last movement of his string quartet called Lift. And it was written for the Izuri Quartet, and they have an amazing album called Blueprinting, which, if you haven't heard of that, go check that out. It was nominated for a Grammy, and very, very cool stuff happening on there. So, Nick's back. We're all good, and this is going to be Danny Clay's Good Night.
I would love the tune, actually.
Thank you.
thank you for tuning in at home. We are Invoke. My name's Zach. That's Carl. Jeff. Behind me over there is Nick. And we're playing Get Music, Get Happy Hour with the Civic Music Association out in Des Moines, Iowa. Thank you so much for having us on. Thanks to all of your audience who's tuning in now. We're going to pull up some different chats available to us at the moment and get some of your questions answered if you have any.
Well, I tried having Restream up, but it's not showing anything.
I have Restream up.
So let's see.
I can pull up their YouTube. But I don't see anything on their YouTube.
Oh, it's an unlisted link. That's why. It's in our chat.
Oh, but it's
Facebook. Right.
So. Getting there. Getting there. Sorry, too much technology stuff happening. As you can see, we're in the backyard, so it's not exactly the best for Wi-Fi things. Let's see what you guys are commenting on. Actually, no comments yet. So if you have any comments.
Live chat. Not chats.
Okay.
Yeah, let's so if you're watching out, take some time. Just type in any questions you might have. We're gonna do one more quick one, and then kind of take a larger, like 5 to 10 minute break, and chill out with y'all. Carl's got a beer over there. He might talk about that for a second. And this one is "Lift" by Paul Bianco.
Call, sir. We look out for each other here. They're both.
The birds are lovely. They're giving us some applause now. It's very hot. And it's getting very humid as like it's cooling down. The air is getting heavier for some reason.
A lot of humidity up
going on. Ken Ava says, cool, Jeff got it. Jeff got his own stage.
That's right.
Hey, Ken. Ken Avis is a great, amazing guitar player in the Baltimore, Maryland area. You should definitely check him out. He was our mentor back in 2015 at the Strathmore Arts Center, where we were artists in residence for like a month. It's a lot of fun. Does anyone have their Facebook open? They might have some.
I'm trying to pull up there.
But in the meantime, while we pull up some stuff, Carl, do you want to talk about your beer?
I thought you said your beard.
Your beard.
It's like
my
we
beard.
Can't see it. It looks like an anchor.
It's huge. My beard is huge. You can't know if I'm lying or not. I am lying. It's not that huge right now. So, all honesty, normally what I do is I get some Austin beer and I bring it in. This is from Odell Brewing today. I didn't really plan ahead with this. It's from Fort Collins, Colorado. But it's a pretty good beer. Mountain Standard IPA. Actually, you should read the back. It's kind of interesting. This is Mountain Standard, a tribute to our backyard and Rocky Mountain lifestyle. So maybe we're wishing we're in the mountains right now where it'd be a little drier. It's hand-selected, which is cool. Modern American hop varieties build layers of complex hop flavors with juicy tropical notes and bold, vibrant aromas. It's pretty cool. Actually, I really do like this beer. It's very light for an IPA. But yeah, this is my beer. Usually I like to showcase an Austin beer. Today I only bought Odell. So I dropped the ball a little bit, but it's a good beer. Cheers.
When you're isolated for this long, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You got to mix it up.
Start losing your mind a bit.
Any questions on the Facebook?
There's no questions. Just thanks you all for joining us. Tim Marr says, sounds great. So nice to hear you live. Hey, Tim.
Thanks, Tim. Thanks
These
for coming.
These is what you need, says Matt Kalanen.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry.
Julie Curry says, Urbandale here. Love the edgy pieces.
Ooh, love the edgy pieces, as do we. Keeps us warm out here in this like 90 degree weather. So.
Civic Music Association asks, what's your favorite Austin beer?
Let's go down the line.
Ooh, I can talk about my favorite Austin beer. I love me some Blue Owl. They are a sours only brewery. And they have a bunch of cool stuff. They do a lot of experimenting. So they have a sour red ale, which is really good. They had like a sour, something dark, like a Van Damme. It's like a sour black IPA or something crazy like that. Super good. But all their stuff is sours, and it's very refreshing for those hot Austin days and nights. So there you have it.
And my favorite Austin beer is the Thirsty Goat Amber Ale. It's kind of the most basic beer, but Thirsty Goat somehow makes it quite refreshing. Yeah. So.
My favorite, I guess, Texas beer, I'm going to branch out a little bit. They're close enough to Austin, but from Independence Brewery. It's called Peach Emoji, and mostly just because I love the name. And it literally on the can, it's a peach-flavored sour, so going along with Nick and the sours, but Peach Emoji is great. It's a sour, but it's not so sour that you can't enjoy it like on a really hot day. It doesn't like, you know, pull all the moisture out of your mouth immediately. And yeah, it tastes like peaches, so it's great. It's awesome.
And Steve asked if you have a good whiskey tonight.
I do not. Thank you, Steve, for asking about my whiskey. I was going to mention that I was going to answer all the things. So people who watch our streams regularly, because we do a regular Friday night 7 p.m. Central stream, know that I usually incorporate a whiskey beverage into my rituals, and I very much enjoy such libations. If I had to choose a local whiskey distiller, it'd be Balcones up in Waco. They do a lot of awesome varieties of whiskeys, and they have great blenders on their team, and stuff that's within the box and some stuff that's way out of the box. Different kinds of wood for smoking things. It's crazy. But if I had to choose beer, definitely Jester King out in the outskirts of Austin. They also, in keeping with the sour theme, they do sour and funky stuff.
They ship.
Jester King ships. It's kind of a crazy, it's a delicious just everything they do is awesome, but particularly their spontaneously fermented line, where I mean, they pride themselves in kind of doing everything in the Belgian way, but with all local Texas ingredients. So spontaneous fermentation and aging in barrels and mixing things that way. And it's just, it ends up in some really, with some really awesome beverages. Any more questions?
Sharon Gilbert, by Friday Night Fix. Questions, does the humidity mess up your tuning?
Yes. Does it ever?
It does.
It does, but surprisingly, my violin must be, well, actually, my violin's great. I like my violin's holding in there right now.
Yeah, can you repeat the question?
The question was, does the humidity affect our tuning? And the answer is yes. And the heat is really what kind of loosens up the strings, and you always go flat. So we have to keep on retuning to figure that out. And then the humidity also, when you start sweating more, it makes it harder to actually like grip your bow, because the bow wood gets really kind of like sweaty, and then the fingerboard gets really pretty gross too. And then also what can happen on my earlier today was that your kind of rosin on your bow gets kind of gunky, so you have to, I had to scrape mine off with a brush, and so it can, but that kind of helped. Yeah, it's hard. Any more questions?
That's all that I'm seeing. Any on Facebook?
Jester King is also beautiful.
Yeah, hopefully we can. We haven't gone to Iowa yet. That's still on the docket. So hopefully one day we can see y'all there, and you can tell us your favorite brews, and we'll go make sure we hit them up. Mm-hmm. And we're going to continue on now with a rather longer piece. It's our reimagination of Beethoven's epic string quartet, Opus 131, in C sharp minor. And we all took a turn at one of the seven movements, except Carl did three. So thanks, Carl, for taking that. And it's just a reimagining of each of the movements for this particular string quartet. Right now, you know, it's important in the classical music world to be creating your own stuff and reimagining these older things with, you know, trying to move forward in time and make things relevant again. So that's what we're trying to do with this piece. This is what we're calling Project 131. Caveat, the third movement, which is usually we have some tech wizardry happening, but because we're outside, there's a lot of moving parts. That one's going to be omitted. So we're just going to go straight from 2 to 4.
Tell them it's only 45 seconds.
It's only 45 seconds long anyway.
We could do
45 minutes of silence if that would appease.
What would John Cage want?
You wouldn't want
Rachel
at all.
That's accurate.
So this is Project 131.
That's all we wrote.
And that's all we wrote. Beethoven wrote a lot more than that.
It was only 20 minutes, but the original is 45, so you should thank us for really giving you an abridged version.
Yeah, be grateful.
Thank you so much for coming. It's been such a fun time playing. You know, before the quarantine happened, which was already now 4 months ago, almost 4 months ago, we were playing together every day, a couple hours a day, and then we're on the road for about a month and a half almost, so... It's been nice, but it's also great to come back and still be able to play somewhat together, even amongst the circumstances. So thank you all for joining us on this experiment and this adventure of life. And we're going to, do we have any questions immediately? Or? Well, we'll just, we'll be online and we'll make sure that we'll hit you up afterwards on the street, on anywhere you commented. We'll try to get back to you about any questions you might have had. Thanks again to Peter and everybody at the Civic Music Association for having us. We really, really appreciate it. We really love making music for people that are actually listening, so thank you. And we're going to end it with a piece that we just put together today, actually, but it's been one that has been on our minds recently, and it's by Jonathan Bingham. It's called Diamond. It's the second movement of his first string quartet, and it's just an amazing piece. Jonathan is a black composer, and we think it's really important as an all-male, all-white string quartet to be lending our voices to the things that they wrote, and black composers, especially now in this day and age, we really want to represent the communities that we're trying to reach out to the most. And yeah, so I'll leave it at that. This is Diamond by Jonathan Bingham.
Thank you.
thank you all so much for coming. Again, we are in Invoke. Thanks to Civic Music Association for having us today. Really appreciate them hosting our stream. If you want to hear more of John's music, we're going to be premiering one of his pieces very soon. It was supposed to be early April, but then you know what happened. So we haven't played a concert for many moons. But he wrote us a beautiful piece called The Lessons of History. So stay tuned, and we're going to be premiering that ASAP. And we're Invoke, invokesound.com if you want to check us out. And I think that's about it, right? Am I missing anything? Yeah, thank you so much. We're streaming again tomorrow. Is that true?
Yeah.
At what time?
Same time.
Same time tomorrow. So we'll probably do some of the same, some different stuff. And we're part of like a longer show with a few other people tomorrow around the same time. So we'd love to see you there. And I have to run inside because my computer is very far away. So see y'all later.